Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So in today's video, I'm going to introduce you with a very new concept called Generative AI. So Generative AI is basically a subset of machine learning and it can produce a new content. For example, it can produce an image, it can produce a video, it can produce an audio file, it can produce even a total new programming code based on the input that is given to the Generative AI. So let's understand this Generative AI and let's understand the key term associated with this Generative AI. Okay, so let's start with a very basic definition of Generative AI. So what is Generative AI? Generative AI is a type of artificial intelligence technology that can produce various type of contents, for example, text, image, video, audio. It looks like a very simple definition, but don't worry, very soon we move to a more sophisticated way to define Generative AI. With this definition, I think the next question that is coming to your mind is artificial intelligence is not the same as machine learning. We are talking about machine learning, we are talking about the artificial intelligence. Are they not same? Okay, so let's define artificial intelligence and machine learning. So what is artificial intelligence? So artificial intelligence is basically a discipline. It is a branch of computer science that deals with the creation of intelligent agents, which are basically the systems that can reason and learn and act autonomously. So it's basically a discipline. Whereas the machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. It is a program that trains the model from its inputs data. Let's see this diagram and understand what is artificial intelligence and what is machine learning and how they are connected. So now if you see this diagram, the big circle, the outer circle is basically the artificial intelligence. Inside that, the middle circle or the circle with the gray color is basically the machine learning. So machine learning is a type of artificial intelligence. And at the very core, the circle with the orange background is basically called the deep learning. So deep learning is the very core of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is a discipline. Machine learning is a type of artificial intelligence which actually trains the data from its input. And deep learning is the core. So we'll talk about the deep learning very soon in this video. But this is what the difference is between artificial intelligence and machine learning. I'll not call it a difference. I'll rather say this is how the artificial intelligence and machine learning are associated with each other. Okay, so now let's understand the labeled data and unlabeled data. So what is labeled data? So labeled data is basically any type of data which has certain type of characteristics. For example, photo of a cat or height of a human being, or for example, price of a mobile phone. So these are all have certain type of characteristics which can be labeled, and that's why these are called the labeled data. So what about unlabeled data? So any data that does not have any label specifying its characteristics, its identity, its classification can be considered as unlabeled data. For example, photos, videos, text, they don't have any kind of categories or any kind of classification. So that's why they are considered as the unlabeled data. So let's understand the learning model of machine learning. Before doing that, let's recap the definition of the machine learning. Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence which is used to train the model based on the input data that is provided to them, provided to the machine learning. The way the machine learning learn from the input data and train its model, there are two type of ways to do that. One is called the supervised learning model, another is called the unsupervised learning model. Let's understand both of this learning model with a diagram. So as you can see, in the supervised learning model, the input data X is passed to the model and the model predicts the output. Then the predicted output is compared with the expected output, and if the differences between them is too much, then it ended up in error. In this situation, model will try to predict another output, thus trying to reduce the differences between the predicted and the expected output. So that's how the supervised learning worked. Whereas in the unsupervised learning, it's basically an artificial intelligence. In unsupervised learning, in artificial intelligence is a type of machine learning that learns from the data without any human supervision. Unlike the supervised learning, unsupervised machine learning models are given unlabeled data and allowed to discover patterns and insight without any explicit guidance or instruction. In this type of learning, input data, which is X, is being passed to the model and the model will generate a new example. So this is what the supervised learning and the unsupervised learning works. So with that, we come to a place where we can define the deep learning. So what is deep learning? So deep learning is basically a subset of machine learning, as you can see, as you can remember from the previous diagram. So deep learning is basically a subset of machine learning that uses artificial neural network with multiple layers to learn from and make decisions about complex patterns in data. Again, let me explain again. Deep learning is basically a subset of machine learning that uses the artificial neural networks with multiple layers to learn from and make decisions about complex patterns in data. It is inspired by the structure and the function of the human brain, where information is processed through interconnected layers of neurons. So deep learning is being used in multiple applications, for example, image recognition, identifying an object, people seen in the landscape, natural language processing, for example, understanding and generating the human languages, speech recognition, transcribing what I am talking and then transcribing it to a text, for example, medical image analysis. This is being hugely used in medical systems. Self-driving car, there are a lot of self-driving cars today where the deep learning is being highly used. Recommendation system, for example, suggesting products, content based on the user preferences. These are the areas where deep learning is being used heavily today. Okay, so finally, we are in a stage where we can start introducing generative AI. So let's understand generative AI now. So generative AI, as you can see in the screen, is a subset of deep learning. That means it uses artificial neural network and uses supervised, unsupervised, and semi-supervised methods to process both the level and unlabeled data. So this generative AI is basically a subset of deep learning. And that means it can use the neural network that is coming with the deep learning and uses the supervised, unsupervised, or semi-supervised learning method to process both the labeled and unlabeled data. These models are typically trained on vast amount of data. The data could be a text, images, or other form of media. And as the model learns from the data, it develops an understanding of patterns, structures, and relations. Once trained, this model can be prompted to generate your new content. For example, you can ask generative AI to write a poem for you. Or you can ask generative AI to enhance this picture to make it more dynamic, make it look more fancy. So these are the type of things that you can instruct generative AI, and generative AI will give you a more improved version based on what you want. Examples of generative AI application is basically a text generation, image generation. There are a lot of audio generations where you can create musics, video generation, for example, creating short YouTube short videos or any kind of videos, animations, art and design, drug discovery, generating a new drug medicine based on the input that you have given. So these are different type of use cases of generative AI. With the generative AI, there is a term that is very important we need to understand, is called the large language model. So what is large language model? So this large language model, or LLM, is a type of artificial intelligence that are trained on massive amount of data, text data. These models are capable of understanding, generating, and translating human language with a high degree of accuracy. There are also subset of deep learning. They are also subset of deep learning. Some key characteristics of LLM, it's a massive data set. LLMs are trained on billions or even trillions of words, allowing them to learn complex patterns and relationships in the language. Second one is a deep neural networks. These models are built on deep neural networks, which are a type of machine learning algorithm that can learn from a large amount of data. Third one, contextual understanding. LLM can understand the context of a conversation or a piece of text, and it allowing them to generate more relevant and coherent responses. And fourth one is versatility. LLM can be used for a wide range of tasks, including translation, summarization, question answering, and creative writing. So there are two types of deep learning model. One is called the predictive model, another is called the generative model. So let's understand both this model. As you can see in my screen, this is a predictive model. In the predictive model, it is used to classify or predict Typically, it is trained on a labeled or the structured data and learns the relationship between the features of the data points and the labels. So that is what the predictive model is all about. Whereas in the generative one, in the generative model, it generates a new data that is similar to the data it was originally trained, understands the distribution of data and how likely a given example is going to happen or occur, and it predicts a new word in a sequence. So that's what this generative AI model is all about. And it works on the unstructured data, whereas predictive model works on the structured data. With that, the question that is definitely coming to your mind is, how can I differentiate between a predictive model and a generative AI model? So let's understand that. So as you can see in my screen, the easiest way to differentiate between a generative AI model and a predictive model is to find out the output. As you can see in the picture, if the output from the model is natural language, image, video, audio, then it's a generative AI model. Whereas if the output is a number or a probability or a classification, then it's a predictive AI model. So this is the way how you can differentiate between the generative AI model and the predictive AI model. So let's understand the predictive learning and the generative learning, generative AI learning in details. So the top section is basically the predictive learning. So predictive learning always works on the label data. So here is the label data and here is the training code. If both are then passed to the model as an input, then it will produce a prediction or a clusterization. So that is what the predictive AI is all about. This is what the predictive learning works. But in comparison to the predictive learning, the generative learning works in a little different way. The below one is basically how the generative learning works. So as you can see here, it works both on the labeled data and unlabeled data. So labeled data and unlabeled data along with the training code can be passed to the foundation model, and then it generates new content. The new content can be a text, can be a sound, can be a video, can be an image. So this is how the generative AI learning works. Okay, so with that, let's understand how does the generative AI work. So generative AI is basically a type of artificial intelligence that creates new content based on what it has learned from the existing content. So this process of learning from an existing content is called the training, and the result in creation of a statistical model. When given a prompt, generative AI uses this statistical model to predict what an expected response might be, and that generates new content. So if you can see in the screen here, I am passing this text as an input, how are you doing? And then this text is going through a process called transformer, where they have two components called encoding component and the decoding component. Encoding component encodes the input and then decodes it into multiple smaller chunks, and then passes that chunk into this generative pre-trained transformer model. And this transformer model is basically processes those chunks and creates a new output, which is basically, I'm doing good, how are you doing? So that's what this is. This is how the generative AI normally works. You pass the input, it goes through a transformer. Inside transformer, there is encoding and decoding. Encoding is basically encode what is being given as an input. Decode is basically put them in small pieces called chunks, and then passes that chunks to the pre-trained model, generative pre-trained model, and that model is used to create the output. So this is how the generative AI works. So with this one, there is a term called hallucination. So what is hallucination? Hallucination is basically when a generative AI produces an output and the output is not makes any sense. It is totally absurd kind of output is giving generated by the generative AI. That is called the hallucination. But then why the hallucination will happen? Hallucination will happen because of multiple reasons. The model which is used to generate the output is probably not trained on enough amount of data, or maybe it was trained on a very dirty amount of dirty data, or the context that was given to generate the output is not enough. There is not enough context, or the model is not given enough constraint. These are the situations where the hallucination can happen, and hallucination can be a big problem for the transformer because it can make the output text difficult to understand. It can also make the model generate incorrect or misleading output. That's why the hallucination is something that we need to understand. It's also a very important thing to make sure that your model is generating expected or close to expected results. So I think that's all for today. I hope you understand the basic of generative AI. If you have any question, please put that in the comment section of this video. If you like this video, please hit the like icon. Please share this with your friends, with your colleagues. And please finally subscribe to my channel. Click the bell icon so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. I'll be publishing more videos around this generative AI concept. So till then, thank you. Bye-bye.